Hey guys, today we're going to show you how to change out your old school cigarette lighter port or your power port over to a flush mount USB. Okay, the first thing I have to do is we have to remove the old port. So it's much easier on my vehicle to remove it out of the vehicle. You can do this in. So this metal portion, this is the ground section, the center pin over here that is positive. So it's going to be battery, constant, or ignition. And we have to remove this section before we can remove the plastic portion. So inside there's these plastic tabs. Most of them will be like this. And I'm pushing from behind. This is why it's easier, because I'm pushing the housing. And so that way, as I'm applying tension this way, it helps hold it. I did remove this previously. That's why it's coming out a lot easier. So you might have to really push on it hard, invest in a good set of picks and small screwdrivers. Like, I was using this one as well. So this helped to pry from behind. And then you can go ahead and remove this plastic shroud. Now, the best way to do this is to buy a product designed to go into these ports. So we bought one that's designed for this exact diameter. I've done a bunch of installs using more universal stuff where you can hot glue the back end. It really depends on the application. Like, I have room over here, so I'm not modifying this at all. I have lots of clearance in spite of how large this looks. So you see it just goes in there like so, and then you're going to look on the other side, make sure it's straight, and then we can go ahead and put on this jam nut to hold it in place. I do like it because it seems like it's made out of metal, the way it just sounds. Now, not every vehicle is going to be this forgiving, where you have this much room. That's what I'm saying. Like, you have to really know the real estate behind, because this is a pocket. You can't just shave this and make room for a piece, because then you're going to see right through the panel. So make sure you know the real estate of your vehicle, pick the appropriate product. But you see, very simple to install. Because this is a difficult area for me to get to, I'm just going to put a little bit of hot glue on here to help hold this nut in place. It's easily reversible, because hot glue, you can just take your pick or whatever and you can just scrape it off. We've also taken the time to clean up back here, because we're probably never going to go back here. This was the old plug. I've gone ahead and put a little bit of Super 33 tape and then shrink tube with glue just to terminate it. I notice I have a switch here. I added a Deutsch connector. I actually had this hardwired before, but to remove it, I had to cut it. So I figured, just in case I do have to go back in here, add plugs, make everything more serviceable. So all you have to do is plug it in now into the USB coming out of our head unit. Now, keep in mind, try to buy units that have a really short USB pigtail. You don't want it too long. It'll work fine if you're charging your phone typically, or if you're running, like, say, music off a USB thumb drive. Where you might have issues where it's a poor quality unit or too long is Android Auto or Apple CarPlay. So make sure the cable that you're plugging on the front side here is original. You're gonna have the best performance typically. So original Apple or original Samsung or whatever Android phone you have. You see how I used to do it? Like, this was done like well over 10 years ago. So what I did was I cut out a square for a USB cable, because at the time, like, no one was really making these flush mount things. And then you see it's hot glue in the back. It's held up well. Like, even the heat and everything, it does fine. And it's still kind of relevant, because I just keep my little thumb drive in there. But it's really hard to get your hand in there. So if you're taking a phone cable in and out, it doesn't really work. And you see down here, this is a lot nicer. All right, so here you see that's what it looks like installed. So it looks pretty factory. This one's pretty neat too, because when you lift it up, you can see there's an indicator light, so you know it's getting power.